Welcome to our Sunday morning worship service.
The word love gets bandied about all over the place, whether it's on the surface of cards, or it's puppy love and infatuation, and love that's a physical attraction that may not really be love at all. Sometimes so much so that we hear the word love that we're confused in our human relationships and our love relationships versus the kind of love that comes down at Christmas, where God and divine love bends into the human experience in the birth of Christ, and what that kind of love and how deeply and passionately God loves each of us is something that's foreign to many of us in the way that we experience the world. And so it's hard to accept the kind of love for some of us where we haven't been able to love ourselves, let alone our neighbors. But what better way to talk about or experience Advent love than to see it through the eyes of our children this fourth Sunday of Advent, as the children lead us in worship today in pageantry and retelling the story of Jesus' birth through their eyes. So join us in the message of God's love.
Today's scripture reading is from 1 John, chapter 3, verses 11, 16 through 18. For this is the message you have heard before, that we should love one another. We know love by this, that he laid down his life for us. And we ought to lay down our lives for one another. How does God's love abide in anyone who has the world's goods and sees a brother or sister in need, yet refuses to help? Little children, let us love. Not in word or speech, but in truth and action.
love more like Jesus. Help us to see your love present in the person who is rude, to the one who we may consider arrogant, to the one we fear, and to those whom we hold strong judgments. Deepen our ability to love God. Help us to live in a way that shows your love more visibly. Help us to forgive more readily, to listen more attentively, to give our time to one another more freely in love you daily give to us. Amen.
Please join in singing our Advent response song, number 181 of the Father's Love Begotten, verses 1 and 4.
Love be genuine, hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual effect. Outdo one another in showing honor, do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit, serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope, be patient in suffering, persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Extend hospitality to strangers.
Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all.
Welcome to our yearly annual Christmas pageant. And I thank you all for getting out here today. This weather was not the greatest. It wasn't on our side, actually. But we're working the best we can and doing a great job at it. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like, at six different times throughout our pageant, you're going to be asked to sing a couple verses of some well-known Christmas carols, and those lines will be projected up here. And for my actors, my performers, they'll be right back there. See them? On the wall back there, so you can read them from there, okay? Today, I'd like everyone to sit back and relax and remember what it was like when you were a child and you were listening to that famous story, The Night Before Christmas. You know, when Santa came and brought all the gifts and came down the chimney. However, this is going to be called The Real Night Before Christmas. Enjoy. "'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the town, no one was sleeping, too many people around. They had come for the census to be counted in, and so now you know why there's no room at the inn." Oh, little town of Bethlehem.
Donkey so sweet with his bray, he carried a woman with a child on the way. Her name was Mary.
And Joseph came too, to be counted in was the right thing to do.
They stopped at the inn and were ready to pay.
All I have is my stable in which you can stay.
So Joseph and Mary to the stable did go, to prepare a warm place with the donkey in tow. And there at the stable was a cow with a coat, so calm and inviting that Joseph took note. Away in the manger, everyone, please. Resting and Joseph stayed close. Out in the fields, the shepherds were manning their post.
But all of a sudden, a huge star appeared.
And the shepherds all watched as that great star neared.
Hey, look at that. That star is so bright.
Yeah, it's coming so close and lighting the night.
Let's
let's follow that star and see where it goes.
We'll take our animals so nobody knows.
So off they all went in search of that star. And they walked ever so far, while shepherds watched their flocks by night, please. Quiet, and the cow gave a sigh. And when the next thing you heard was one tiny cry, a baby was born. For she knew that our king was born on that night. Angel one.
Soon angels appeared from the heavens above and sang a sweet tune of unending love.
Would everyone help us sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing? With all their sheep too, and they all knelt down, not sure what to do.
But Mary said calmly, "Don't be afraid. Come look at this baby that our God has made."
They had followed that star to the stable that night. My kings are coming in right now, Miss Maria.
But soon, three kings were seen.
To follow that light.
We're going to follow that light.
They had been listening to the angels sing.
They brought beautiful gifts to the newborn king.
We three kings. And that baby grew. A boy, a teacher. Who knew that this was the king that God did send? And you'd think that this would be a good place for the end. But you see, he lives on in our hearts to this day. And so there is only one thing left to say. Let Jesus be your friend and your light. And Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. Joy to the world. Provenzano, Dean, Miss Dina, Barb Compton, Kelly Calpin on the piano, Mrs. Hopley, all the moms and all the dads, we thank you. And now I'm going to count to three, and we're going to do a mannequin challenge. Ready? One, two, three. We thank you. Boys and girls, would you come sit down here in the front on the floor? Everybody, all my performers except for, I believe, the junior choir is going to sing now, so let's all go down here and sit on the floor, please.
this I know, and if there are any other children that are young at heart that want to come up here, we got practically half the congregation up here anyway today. Come on up. There's some room on some risers here. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Good morning, boys and girls. That was fun seeing you guys tell the story of Jesus' birth and Mary and Joseph and the angels and the shepherds and the wise men. Now, I'm going to ask you a tricky question. Put on your thinking caps, your memories. Let me see them. Put them on. Put them on. Who could tell me what that pink candle was last week? Does anybody remember? Oh, yes. Quick. Joy. Did you ask your moms and dads what it was? Did you ask them? They lit another one today. What color was the one they lit today? Yeah. What color was it?
Purple.
And this candle is the candle of Jesus' love and God's love for us. Now, there's one candle in the middle, a white candle, and it's not lit yet. Why isn't that candle lit, do you think? Yeah, what do you think? You forgot, okay. Yeah. We do light it on Christmas Eve. What do you think that candle represents? Does anybody have a good guess? Joy. Yeah, it does. It represents Jesus being born into the world, and he represents all four of those things: peace, hope, love, and joy. Now, boys and girls, I have to have your help today. Can you guys help me? I really need a big help, a big favor. How many of you think you can help me a little bit? This could be a tricky one. How do you know somebody loves you? Tell me some ways that you know somebody loves you. Yeah. All right, maybe you get a kiss from them. You get a hug from them. Yeah.
You ask them.
Sometimes you ask them. Yeah. What else? How they care about you. Yes. How they treat you. Now, I think all of those were very good answers. How do we know? Here's an even bigger question. Really big question. I need your help in a big way on this one. How do you know that God loves you? How do you know that God loves you? Yeah, River. For the Bible tells me so. We just sang it, didn't we? Absolutely. The Bible does tell us. It says that God is love and that God loves us from, guess what it says? From our hairs on our head down to the toes on our feet and everything in between. Everything on the outside and everything on the inside. Everything we think about, everything in our hearts, in our bodies, our souls, and our minds. God loves us completely. And all those things that you said on how you know that your families love you or your good friends love you because they care, because of the way they think about you, because of the way they talk to you, and because when you talk to them, you know how deeply they love you. All those things are true about the way God loves us. And at Christmas time, it's especially important because at Christmas, God comes into the world in the life of Jesus, and he brings and teaches all the people what God's love is like. Jesus' whole life he spent, and you guys just talked about Jesus' birth just now. You shared it with us. Jesus' whole life was about how God loves God's people and how God loves you and me. So this week, what is this week again? What's this week again?
Christmas week.
Christmas week. Are you guys all ready? Hey, boys and girls. Hey, hey, angels. Hey, are you guys ready for Christmas? You guys ready for Christmas? You going to sing for joy? You going to share God's love for everybody? Well, that's what I like to hear. We need a little more spunk today. Yeah, there we go. All right, will you please pray with me this week? And let's pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Okay, boys and girls. Thank you, boys and girls.
Please join in singing verse 2 of Jesus Loves Me. Jesus loves me still today, walking with me on my way, wanting as a friend to give light and love to all who live. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Chaos, because I think that first Christmas was likely pretty chaotic and pretty wild for Mary and Joseph. As we begin a time of prayer, I'd like to invite you to turn in your bulletins to top of page five. You'll see some new names listed there, and those several that we've been praying for some time. But I'd like to add a few names and also give you a few updates. Father-in-law Jerry Topol fell and broke his ankle in two places. He had surgery this past week. Margaret Craig is out of the hospital after a fall and a bone break. Prayers continue for Ray Albert and his boys and for his wife Ann at the sudden death of his son Michael, age 61, last week. Also, I'd ask your prayers for Carl Lorick, our church custodian. His sister, both of his sisters have been in poor health, but last night his sister Judy went to the ICU, and please prayers for her and for Carl and his family. A prayer also for a young family, Deidre and her spouse Jessica, who after especially long pregnancy, lost both of their twin children last night at birth. Please pray for Jessica and Deidre. And a joy for Michelle Krebs, the granddaughter of Evelyn Dickerson, and her young fiancé, Tony, as they marry this Thursday night in Christmas week. And I'm sure there are many others on your thoughts and minds as we think about the relationships and the love that we share as family come in and some of us head out to be with those we love at Christmas. Let us take a moment first of silent prayer to reflect, to give thanks, and to share concerns with God, and then we'll pray together. Let us pray. God, to see Christmas joy through the eyes of children is a gift, almost magical in the way that their eyes light up and they share excitement over the season. But also we're reminded of how deeply you bend to us to reveal yourself to us again and again, not only on the first Christmas, but in all the gifts and beauty that surround us in our day-to-day lives, whether it's a softly falling snow, the way it sits on the trees in a winter wonderland, or it's giving thanks for the blessing of the people in our lives, family and friends and co-workers who bring fullness to our lives and smiles to our faces. For all the blessings you share to us and all the ways that your love surrounds us, even at times when we have turned our backs on you, for the persistent way you keep giving that love, we give you thanks this Advent season as we prepare our hearts for Christmas to receive Christ into our lives again and to deepen our faith, to share that love throughout the world and throughout our daily lives. In the name of Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. this Advent week of God's love, as we offer our gifts and treasures to the church ministries and missions, I'd present to you a special Advent challenge. Nothing physical necessarily. I'm not going to challenge anybody to arm wrestle down in Fellowship Hall, but especially not Roger. But this week, as we're getting ourselves and our families and grocery shopping and all that stuff for Christmas, think about somebody who may be alone this Christmas. Maybe it's in somebody in the church, somebody at work, somebody in their lives. And find a way, whether through the week or Christmas Eve night with your own celebrations, to share God's love with them so that they aren't alone. And that they're reminded not only that you care about them, but there's an amazing God who loves them from head to toe and who has come into this world to see them in love face to face. As we receive the morning offering, let us think about who those people might be in our lives as we celebrate the love of Christ by loving as Christ has loved us. The ushers, please come forward for the morning offering.
I don't care if the house is packed or the strings of lights are broken. I don't care if the gifts are wrapped or there's nothing here to open. Love is not a toy and no paper will conceal it. Love is simply joy that I'm home. I don't care if the carpet's stained, we've got food upon our table. I don't care if it's gonna rain, our little room is warm and stable. Love is who we are, and no season can contain it. Love would never fall for that. We sing, ooh, ooh, ooh. Let love lead us, love is Christ. Why so scared that you'll mess it up when perfection keeps you haunted? All we need is your best, my love, that's all anyone ever wanted. Love is how we do, let no judgment overrule it. Love, I look to you and I sing. Ooh. Ah.
God, thank you for loving us so deeply, even at times when we sometimes struggle to love ourselves. Remind us of the love that comes down at Christmas, lives and breathes amongst us, that would go to the cross in deep love, in the face of our ugliness and worst, and even amidst that pain and suffering, would continue the message of, I love you, I love you, I love you. In Christ our Lord, whose birth, life, and death and resurrection we give thanks for this day, as we seek to return the love that you have first shared with us, we pray, bless these gifts and us to your service through this last week of Advent as we herald in a new Christmas this year. Amen. Our closing hymn is number 218, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Visitor with us here today, as part of this journey of faith we share, we join hands with our neighbors beside us and behind us as a symbol that we walk this journey together. Times I think we complicate faith. We always try to figure out how it is to be better disciples, and sometimes it's the children that remind us that the most basic building block of faith, the thing that Jesus says all the law, all the prophets hang on, is how we love each other. May God's love go with you beyond these walls, everywhere you go this week, and throughout this season and beyond it. And may we be measured by how we love as Jesus has loved us as Christians. Go in.
Ancient words ever true, changing me and changing you. We have come.
again so much for worshiping with us today. Please bundle up and come back at 7 o'clock for our concert tonight. It's going to be a really, really great time. But before you go, come on up and join me in our postlude, I Pray on Christmas. I pray on Christmas that the Lord will see me through. I pray on Christmas He'll show me what to do. I pray on Christmas He'll help me lead the way. And I pray on Christmas He'll take me by the hand. I pray on Christmas that the sick will soon be strong. I pray on Christmas the Lord will hear my song. I pray on Christmas that God will lead the way. And I pray on Christmas He'll get me through another day. I pray on Christmas. I pray through another day. I pray on Christmas all our problems gonna be worked out. I pray on Christmas God will show us what love's about. I pray on to do your will each day. And I pray on Christmas that I'll be with you in heaven someday. All right, one more time, you gotta sing it with me, please. I pray on Christmas that the sick will soon be strong. I pray on Christmas the Lord will hear my song. I pray on Christmas that God will lead the way. And I pray on Christmas He'll get me through another day. I said He'll get me through another day. One more time, He'll get me through another day. Woo, thank you so much. Have a great week. Stay warm.
Advent and Christmas, it's a time of preparation and celebration. Whether you're going out and getting a tree, making those holiday shopping lists, taking those balls of Italian twinkle lights out of the garage and trying to untangle them to decorate for the house, having in-laws and outlaws come and join you, and the joy and sometimes tension of family at Christmas. But what about you? How does this faith in the one we call Jesus change your life so that it's distinguishable from any other life that's around us? Truly a life that is changed and transformed by the good news that has come down and lived and taken on flesh amongst us. I invite you this Advent season and Christmas to come join us to hear this life-changing message about how God in Christ makes life full, powerful, purposeful, and defines every aspect of who we are. Come on Sunday mornings at 9:30, every Sunday from now until Christmas Eve, and on Christmas Eve at 4:30 for a family service, 8 o'clock for a contemporary worship, and 11 o'clock for traditional Christmas service. Or join us on Christmas Day to celebrate after all the gifts and all the food has been eaten, the stockings cleared out. Come join us at 11 o'clock for caroling, for a Christmas Day message, and for joy and celebration as we welcome the newborn King. But come, whether you've got a church or not, whether you've believed before or not, come and see how this King of Kings can change your life. Join us this Christmas.